In this video, we'll demonstrate the critical safety elements of removing the draping of an ambulance patient care space after the transport of a person under investigation or confirmed with a highly infectious disease. This video will assist emergency medical services in developing a standardized procedure to remove the drape within the patient care space of an ambulance that has been used to transport a person under investigation for a highly infectious disease or a patient who has a confirmed highly infectious disease. The following assumptions are being made with regards to this guideline. All people who are involved with decontamination of an ambulance have received education and training and demonstrated the necessary competencies for managing patients and equipment with Ebola or other special pathogens. The transporting agency has procedures for managing patients with Ebola or other special pathogens. The transporting agency conducts training and exercises regarding decontaminating ambulances and equipment. Before transport, the patient care space of the ambulance was draped with protective plastic or an off-the-shelf draping product. If the pathogen is considered a Category A select agent, waste should be considered Category A infectious waste and should be packaged appropriately for disposal. Personal protective equipment should be selected with consideration for both biological and chemical exposures that are expected. Team members working within the hot zone and the warm zone should use filter cartridges approved for biological and chemical use in their PAPA. PPE should be donned and doffed with an observer according to specific protocols. This guidance can be used in conjunction with other CDC guidance for management of patients with Ebola or other special pathogens. Highly infectious diseases have various modes of transmission. Appropriate infection control measures must be implemented that adequately protect the team from exposure or contamination. To remove the ambulance draping, you will need the following equipment. Appropriate PPE ensembles for all operations team members. Approximately 12 feet by 12 feet sheet of 6 mil plastic. Disinfectant wipes. Hand sanitizer. Standard patient care gloves in a variety of sizes. A roll of red biohazard bags. These should be 24 inches by 36 inches and autoclavable. A pack of autoclave bags, clips for autoclave bags, biohazard bins. Line each bin with a biohazard bag for transport to autoclaving. Alternatively, Category A boxes lined with a biohazard bag, trauma shears or scissors. This process is designed for a four-person team. Two people will be donned in PAPA-level PPE and work within the hot zone. One person donned in PAPA-level PPE will start working within the warm zone, transitioning to the hot zone when the plastic sheeting has been removed. All PAPA-level PPE should be fitted with filter cartridges approved for biological and chemical use. The fourth person will be positioned in the area designated as the cold zone. They will be donned in standard precautions, including a face shield, N95 respirator, double gloves, boot covers, and gown. This person will supervise the decontamination of the ambulance, placement of the waste bags in the bins, and supervise the PPE doffing process. There are several steps to set up your decontamination site. Preferably, the ambulance decontamination site will be a large, isolated, enclosed structure capable of protecting the vehicle and the decontamination team from weather elements. It should be well ventilated, climate controlled, and have controlled access. Establish a secure perimeter outside the building for the safety of the public and the decontamination personnel. Include considerations for waste management, security plans, public perception, and media visibility when selecting the decontamination site. Place a sheet of 6 mil plastic, approximately 12 feet by 12 feet, on the ground outside the back of the ambulance at the established work zone. Define and mark the hot, warm, and cold zones of contamination around the ambulance. These areas will require PPE to enter. Place biohazard bins lined with biohazard bags next to the outside edge of the plastic sheet. While one member of the hot zone team remains outside the ambulance, the other should enter the patient care space. Any visible patient body fluids should be soaked up with absorbent material. The area should then be wiped thoroughly with an EPA-registered disinfectant. The hot zone team member within the patient care space should then wipe all remaining exposed areas within the space. The ambulance draping and equipment in the ambulance should be very clean before any removal begins. Using disinfectant wipes, disinfect the outside of any pre-positioned but unused medical equipment. These should still be inside the protective bags they were placed in. Once disinfected, the unused equipment is passed out of the patient care space and placed into the warm zone by the exterior hot zone team member. Any equipment used or removed from the bags must be assessed to determine if it can be properly decontaminated and disinfected, or if it needs to be disposed of. This includes removal of the gurney. It should be removed from the patient care space, but remain in the hot zone. Gurney decontamination may be best done by the patient care team personnel who know the details of the transport. The warm zone team member should enter the ambulance through the side door behind the plastic on the clean side, starting at the front of the patient care space and working towards the rear. The warm zone team member removes the tape and draping from the walls, rolling it down, outside in, towards the interior of the space. The hot zone team member within the patient care space should not touch the tape prior to its removal from the walls, as this could cause contamination of the walls. As the draping is removed, the interior hot zone team member will use trauma shears to gently cut the plastic into segments small enough to fit into the autoclave bags, or biohazard bags, depending on your waste removal plan. The warm zone team member must only touch the clean side of the draping as it is removed. The exterior hot zone team member will hold open an autoclave or biohazard bag into which the interior hot zone team member will place the small pieces of interior plastic. The exterior team member will then gooseneck, clip, and place each bag into the lined bins. When all of the plastic has been passed out of the patient care area, bagged and binned, the interior hot zone team member can exit the ambulance and decontaminate any soiled areas of their PPE. When decontaminating, do not use a circular back and forth motion. Start at the hood and wipe in a downward motion away from the body, replacing wipes regularly. Then proceed to the warm zone and doff the PPE supervised by the cold zone team member. If the chair within the patient care space was covered with biohazard bags, these should be carefully removed by the warm zone team member. Place the chair cover bags in autoclave or biohazard bags, gooseneck, clip, and place in a biohazard bin. The warm zone team member remaining in the ambulance should now address any PPE contamination using disinfectant wipes. The remaining exterior hot zone team member should enter the ambulance to assist the warm zone team member in manually disinfecting the interior of the patient care space using disinfectant wipes. Both should limit mechanically generated aerosols while wiping the space. Begin at the front of the patient care space and systematically wipe top to bottom, front to back. Verbally calling out surfaces will help you be consistent in cleaning. Drop used wipes into an autoclave bag that is positioned behind you that will be removed, clipped, and placed in the bins when finished. After the interior of the ambulance is decontaminated, both team members should leave the patient care space to the exterior hot zone. Manually wipe down the ambulance's exterior patient loading doors, latches, and handles. The remaining exterior of the ambulance does not require a full disinfectant wipe down. After decontamination of the ambulance, the crew in PAPA level PPE should decontaminate. Disinfectant wipes should be placed in an autoclave bag, goosenecked, clipped, and placed in a biohazard bin. They can then doff their PPE according to supervised doffing protocols. The doffing order will be from dirtiest to cleanest. The plastic sheet should be folded up and placed into an autoclave bag, then into a biohazard bin by personnel in standard PPE. The driver's compartment can be cleaned by personnel in standard PPE after all hot zone areas are cleaned, unless a direct contamination of the compartment occurred with the patient or patient's body fluids. Some organizations use tertiary cleaning, such as UVC light treatment or vaporized hydrogen peroxide, inside the ambulance patient care space upon completion of physical decontamination. The draping removal and ambulance decontamination process is a slow and deliberate procedure. It requires skills developed through regular training and exercises. We hope this video is helpful as you develop your specific plans.